Hello everyone, welcome to the tutorial on the C programming language. This is our fourth lecture in which we will discuss about the flowchart in the pseudocode. As we discussed in the previous lecture, algorithm is a sequence of the steps that to be followed to solve a particular problem. So algorithm can be expressed in a two way. One is the flowchart and one is the pseudocode. As the name suggests, flowchart is nothing but the diagrammatic representation of the sequence of the steps, while the pseudocode is English like a language to represent the sequence of the steps. Now, as a programming point of view, problem can be represented in any way as a flowchart and the pseudocode. Now, programmer is an essential person that will translate the algorithm or steps expressed in informal way into steps that can be understood by a computer. That is known as a program. So the language that can be understood by a computer, that is known as the programming language. Now let's first discuss about the flowchart. As we discussed, the flowchart is nothing but the graphical representation of an algorithm using a standard symbol that includes a set of the various standard shaped boxes that are interconnected by flow lines. Flow lines can have arrows that represent the direction of the flow. Activities are written within a box in an English language, as well as the flowchart can use to communicate between the programmer and the business person. Next, we will discuss about the advantages of the flowchart. First, communication. It provides a quickly logic, idea and description of an entire algorithm. Next, effective analysis. That means it will provide a clear overview of the entire problem statement. Proper documentation. It provides a document that the steps that should be followed the algorithms help us to understand its logic. Next one is efficient coding. More easy with the comprehensive flowchart as a guide and easy in a debugging and program maintenance. Debugging means we will check our program. It is going to be easy to check your program using a flowchart. In the case of adding a new functionality for a maintenance, that should be easy to understand using a flowchart. Now let's discuss about the symbols that is used in a flowchart. As we discussed that the algorithm is nothing but the sequence of the finite number of the steps. That means your algorithm must have a start and ending. Same as the algorithm can be representation into a flowchart. So flowchart must have also start and end symbol that can be represented using this oval, that is the terminating symbol that makes the starting and end point of the system. It usually contains the words like start and end. Next symbol is a arrow. A line is a connector that shows the relationship between the representative shapes. Next we will discuss about the input output symbol. As we know that the every problem statement have a specific input, and based on this input we will get some output that can be represented using this symbol that represent the material or information entering and leaving the system. Consider one example, the product management system, in which the customer order is as an input and the product we will get as an output that can be represented using this symbol. Next, we will discuss about the process symbol. As we know that based on some input, there are some steps that should be executed. That is known as the process that can be represented using this rectangle symbol. The box represents a single step as well as the entire sub-process. Okay, let's take one example. Suppose we are adding a two number, then C is equal to A plus B. That is a single step that can be represent using this rectangle box. Now suppose we are swapping a two number using a third number variable. A and B are a two number and we are using C as a third number. So we can write like this: C is equal to A is equal to B, and B is equal to C. That is the entire sub process that can be represent using this rectangle. Our next symbol is the decision symbol that can be represented using this diamond shape. That will be your decision and the branching point. So there are some situations in which you have to decide whether you have to perform this action or this action based on some conditions. If your condition is true, there are some sequence of the steps you have to follow. Otherwise, you have to follow some another steps that can be represented using this shape. The condition, you can write the condition within this diamond shape. Okay, these are the basic symbols that can be used to draw a flowchart. Now we will discuss with this example how we can implement this symbol to draw a particular flowchart. Now let's take an example to learn how to draw a flowchart based on the algorithm. We had already discussed this algorithm to addition of the two number. So this is the algorithm that is start with the start and ending with the stop. So based on this algorithm, we will see how we can draw the flowchart. Here is the flowchart by following these steps. First, we have to start with the start symbol that is represent using this symbol, and the end that can be represent using this symbol. For an input, we will use this parallelogram as an input. We are reading a two number A and B. For a processing, we will use the rectangle that will represent C is equal to A plus B. Again, we will display C as an output that can be represented using this symbol parallelogram. To display C as a number of A and B. So this is the graphical represent of this algorithm to add a two number and display the addition of a number into a C. Let's take another example that is based on a decision. We will draw a flowchart to check whether the number is odd or even. We will read one number from the user, then check whether the number is odd or even. If your number modulo 2 equal to 0, that means your number is even. Otherwise, your number is odd. Suppose we are giving n is equal to 5. Now, 5 modulo 2 is equal to 1. That means this condition is false. That means your number is an odd number. And if I am giving n is equal to 4, that means 4 modulo 2 equal to 0, that means you are writing a given number. This is the entire flowchart that will check whether your number is odd or even. Okay, let's take another example of a flowchart to find the largest of a three different number. Here I am giving an algorithm that will find the largest number of given A, B and C. Observe this flowchart whether it is correct or not. This flowchart is not correct. Why? Because here instead of print C, we have to print B, and instead of print B, here we have to print C. How? Let's take. We will read these three number A, B and C from the user. We will check whether your number A is greater than B. Again, we have to check if A is also greater than C, then your number A is the largest number. Else, your C is the largest number. If A is not greater than B, then we will check whether B is greater than C. If it is true, then your B is largest number, otherwise your C is the largest number. Okay, this is all about the flowchart. Next, we will discuss about the pseudocode. Okay, what is the pseudocode? A pseudocode is an English-like a language. Pseudocode is not an actual programming language, so it cannot be compiled into executable code. So pseudocode is nothing but it is used as short terms or simple English language syntaxes to write a code for a programs before it is actually converted into a specific programming language. Okay, now let's take the same example that we had discussed. Addition of the two number, we have so how to write the algorithm as well as the how to draw the flowchart for the same. This is the flowchart to add a two number. So how we can write a pseudocode for this same problem? First, you have to read a one number, then read a second number, then declare a variable C in which you can add number A and B. Then we can write C is equal to A and B, and we will print C. This is the pseudocode of your program for adding a two number. Here we had discussed about the flowchart and pseudocode. Next, we will discuss different type of the programming language. Thank you.